You know, folks, sometimes I'll pop a melatonin and try to get a good night's sleep, try to catch up on my sleep a little bit more, and sometimes that means I'll sleep for about 13 hours to catch up on the disaster I've been having lately. And you know what? Frontier, they wait and they watch for my sleeping pattern, and they know, and they tease DLC whilst I'm asleep. So I'm a little bit late to this party, but we're here anyway. A little bit earlier on the Jurassic World Evolution 2 Twitter, as you can see, Frontier have teased the next DLC. Something seems a little strange about these lagoons park managers, but we can't seem to work out what it could be. Any ideas? Now, they've posted a little video, but of course, this is Twitter quality. I'm going to load up that on full screen and let's check out this little hint that they've posted. So there we go, a very subtle teaser. I actually really like it as a teaser, just showing a lagoon in action with something swimming around in the distance. So we're going to play through it again and we're going to pause where necessary. But it's safe to say this definitely looks to be a megalodon. Our first little glimpse is actually here, sort of in the middle lower area there. You can just about see something moving around here. Just a little glimpse there, something white, something shining in the depths of the water. But this shot is really the giveaway. When I look around here, right in the middle, I'll zoom in for that. We'll do a normal one and then we'll zoom in. You can just see something swimming down. Oh, it's this one. This one's the giveaway, I should say. I apologize. There we go. We see it over here on the left approaching, and then it's that little bit there. That's really the giveaway. This point right here. You can see, first of all, if we go back to about here, you see, first of all, very clearly, we've got a strong example of counter shading going on here. You can see whatever's in the water here, we've got this sort of dark upper body and this lighter lower body. And then as it moves around, you can see it curves around. We've got a fin here, and then you can see the caudal fin come in like that as well, in that very, very definitive shark sort of shape. And whilst there are a bunch of prehistoric sharks out there, I think we all know the prehistoric shark that is more popular and much more likely to feature. And that is, of course, the Megalodon, which is a big old boy. Now, I'm quite curious about this. So this one's an interesting one as well, because you don't see much on this image unless I'm crazy. This one has less than the others. It's the last one. I don't see any. Like, maybe I'm crazy. I don't see anything on this one. Am I mad? I could be. So the Megalodon's going to be a really interesting test for Frontier as well. I'm watching it here. It looks quite thick. So a lot of people, they render Megalodon quite like a typical great white shark. Quite like the great white shark, you know, from Jaws and stuff. That's how they'll render a Megalodon, just a larger version of that. Megalodon, you know, could go up to 50 feet or so. This was a very large animal. But Megalodon probably didn't look like that. Whilst it may have had the coloration and the basic body shape, I suppose, of a great white, it would have been chunky, or at least that's the general idea at the moment, that it would have been thick, it would have been fat, this thing was a beast, you know. And it didn't quite have that sleek appearance that a modern great white shark would have. This would be a much more bulky, fairly terrifying creature. Now, the really interesting thing about this, so we've been talking lately about what are they going to do for the next DLC? How are they going to... Oh God, I wonder if that's what it can't be. I've been talking a lot lately about what's the next DLC going to be, because this is the first one where there isn't a movie tie-in. You know, they've done Camp Cretaceous, they've done Jurassic World Dominion, we had Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom in the past games. All the major DLCs for this game, as in non-dinosaur packs. Dinosaur packs are always random, but the major DLCs, the story-based DLCs with new buildings and new maps and stuff, they've all been themed around films, because it's a good way to boost your marketing, it's a good way to get some free promotion, stuff like that. Now, of course, there isn't a new Jurassic World property on the way. However, you know what's just come out in the cinemas as it happens? The Meg 2. Now, I don't know if this was done on purpose, but if you were going to release a Megalodon-themed DLC, maybe, you know, an aquatic-themed DLC in general, you know, maybe we're looking at general updates to lagoons and how they function, maybe we'll finally get lagoon tour vehicles and stuff like that. Some things we've been asking for, you know. If they're teasing this pack with the Megalodon, I've got to assume it is maybe a Lagoon-themed pack in general. I really am trying to find something on this one. No, I don't see it. But if you're going to release a DLC with a Megalodon and with a Lagoon theme, why not release it at the same time as the big Megalodon film of the summer, as it happens? I don't think it'll be a Meg 2 themed... I don't think it's going to be a tie-in DLC. But, you know, it's well-timed. And I think that's probably on purpose, which is interesting. So, I'm very curious to see what this DLC is going to be. You know, we're expecting more than a dinosaur pack. We're expecting a full-fledged DLC with new buildings and maps, storylines, all that kind of jazz. Is it going to be about the Megalodon? Is it going to be about aquatic creatures? Is this kind of just throwing us off the scent a little bit? Is it a general story DLC about something else that happens to contain a Megalodon? Is it a Meg 2 DLC? You never know, I suppose. And I'm hopeful the Megalodon we see is cool. It sticks out. It doesn't just look like a great white shark, because you want a little bit more variety. Hopefully it looks like a Megalodon. Frontier have been really bringing their A-game with the designs lately. You know, look back to the Feathered Species pack. So, quietly confident. It looks good. It's very exciting to finally get it in the game. It's an animal we've been trying to get hold of for a very, very long time. I've played tons of Megalodon mods over the years, but very, very exciting stuff. There's at least a teaser, there's a hint of something on the way, and of course we know August 9th, so 1 week today actually, there is a Frontier live stream, which is called a special live stream, and probably has something to do with the DLC, given that we've just got our first teaser. So hopefully we'll find out some more info very, very soon. Until then, thank you very much for joining me. Apologies, it was a little bit late. I was asleep. I'm very annoyed about that. But I'll bring you any news as soon as we see it. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much of as always. Bye-bye.